There is no shortage of life on Earth. Everywhere you look, there are living things. They are both visible and invisible to the naked eye. But is it really possible that Earth is the only place in the universe that has the right conditions to harbor life? Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, are we alone in the universe? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and let us know a question you have always wanted to know the answer to. Our universe stretches 13.8 billion light years. In our universe alone, there's an estimated 10 billion galaxies, 1 billion stars per galaxy, and orbiting those stars there are trillions, and I mean trillions of planets. 1 billion trillion is the best estimate. That's a lot of planets. Surely, with 1 billion trillion planets out there, there has to be at least some of them that harbor the right conditions to support life. Actually, statistically speaking, 25% of those billion trillion planets should be within the Goldilocks zone, which allows for liquid water on the surface of the planet. And then 10 to 20% of those are around the same size as Earth. Well, despite all of these promising statistics, so far scientists have failed to find any evidence of life on other planets. Could it really be possible that we are alone in this vast universe? There are many experts who believe that complex life, other civilizations, must exist, and they must have existed throughout the course of the history of our universe. SETI founder Frank Drake believes there are thousands of civilizations. Carl Sagan believes there are 1 million. There are also many experts who believe the contrary. They make the case that we have no idea how many other planets harbor life, so how can we predict other civilizations exist? It could be that life on Earth was the result of a series of flukes. That's right, one improbable fluke after another, and then all of a sudden, you've got life. Okay, maybe not all of a sudden. In order to get a human civilization, there are three main steps that needed to happen. Number one, abiogenesis. This is where raw ingredients associated with organic processes became life forms. Number two, single-cellular life has to survive for billions of years before evolving into multicellular or intelligent life. And number three, that multicellular life has to become intelligent enough to become a technological civilization that would be able to explore the universe, transmit signals, or listen for other forms of intelligence. Abiogenesis is likely a lot more common in the universe. It could have occurred or is occurring somewhere in our own solar system. But intelligent life? Sure. Maybe there have been other civilizations throughout the entire existence of the universe, but we might be the only one that exists right now. Think about it. We've only been technologically advanced for about 100 years. That's an infinitesimal speck on the timeline of the existence of the universe. The truth is, we just don't know right now. We've been searching and listening for over 60 years, and we haven't found any evidence of life. I can shove statistics down your throat all day long, but without concrete proof, we don't know. But here's how you should look at things. Right now, the life that exists on planet Earth is the only life that we know of. That means that life is precious and rare. Protect it and don't waste it. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, you'll love our playlist, Biggest Science Questions, clickable on the screen right now. And don't forget to subscribe to notifications by clicking the bell, and we'll see you in the next video.